feet were feeders. Jacob called it Bethel because it was nothing but the house of God. Feeling good to be in church this morning. Feeling good to be in church this morning. Another morning. Can you hear me there? Good, good. Surely we can say that God, none other but God. I want the choir to help me sing a little song here. I don't know if you know it, but it's very simple. My brother Michael taught me something way back. I'll never forget it. He said, when we in this day and age go to war, we do things a little differently than what they did back in the days of old. First thing you want to do is get your spy satellites up. Got to spy out the enemy territory. They don't even see what's going on, but you can see what they're doing. And you want to plan your strategy to hit them at perhaps the strongest point first. And as the day of war draws on, what they do in the United States is they send up certain big jets. And they send off certain frequencies that jams up the enemy radar. They have to do that because before they send their flyer boys in, they've got to clear the airways. Before we can get the presence of the Lord to come down, we've got to clear the airways. The Bible said that the devil is the prince of the power of this air. And if we're going to have liberty, we're going to have to learn how to clear the airways. Lifting up Jesus. Telling him how much I love him. Because I want the airways to be cleared that the angels can come down and rest with the people of God. Junior choir, I think it's going to be very simple. It's, I just can't stop praising his name. I just can't stop praising his name. I just can't stop praising his name, Jesus. Can you handle that? Come on. I just can't stop praising his name. I just can't stop praising his name. I just can't stop praising his name. Jesus. A little faster. Come on now. I just can't stop praising his name. I just can't stop praising his name. I just can't stop praising his name. Jesus.
Thank you.
dangerous place to be this morning, because the Spirit has been so rich. And I tossed all night. I was up early this morning. I went to bed late and said, Lord, I hope this is what your people need for this morning. I'm not like some that will let you know that this is the Word of God. I'm careful when I say that. Because if you say God said, then it's got to be dead on. There's no maybe with God. It's got to be dead on. This morning we read in the book of Numbers, chapter 7. In just two verses I'm going to read, two or three. Reading Bishop Dunn in his absence. I feel him here and I feel kind of let down. I don't see him behind.